रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? होप ऑल ऑफ यू विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पेज नंबर 106 एंड एज वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 7, दैट इज़ मनी। आर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ शॉपिंग। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द शॉपिंग, बट वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द मनी एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू बाय द थिंग्स। ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, लुक एट दिस। द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज सम चिल्ड्रन गो शॉपिंग, सम ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन, यू एंड सम ऑफ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड सिबलिंग्स आर गोइंग फॉर द शॉपिंग। हेयर आर द थिंग्स दे बाय। सो स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आई एम हैविंग सम थिंग्स दैट आर यू आर गोइंग टू बाय। ओके, हेयर फर्स्ट इज द टॉय कार। अ टॉय कार कॉस्ट 56. Here is a cocoa that is of 45 rupees. Next, here is a piece of a cake that is of rupees 27. Next, here are the socks. They are costing 35 rupees. And here is a beautiful flower band and this is of rupees 5. While in the last, here we are having a bear, a toy that is of 75 rupees. Okay students, now what we are going to do? How much does each child spend? First of all, we are going to find out that a child is buying what things and what are the price of that things and how much money do they have left and what amount of money will they left after buying the things. Okay students, first of all, in the first part A, here I am reading the statement. Anila has rupees 100 to spend. How many rupees Anila had? Anila has 100 rupees. Okay, she buys, and what is the shopping of the Anila? Anila is buying a cake and a can of cocoa. So students, first of all, we are going to add the money of the cake and the cocoa, because first of all, in the shopping mall, we are going to take the things, we will count their money and then go to the counter to pay the cash for this. Okay, so students, first of all, look at this, the amount of the cake and the amount of the can of cocoa. Cake is of 27 rupees and cocoa is of 45 rupees. So students, we are going to add these both things, rupees 27 and rupees 45. Okay students, let's add them. 7 plus 5 is 12. 2 is written here, 1 in the 10th column, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So students, Anila is spending 72 rupees on the cake and the can of the cocoa. Now students, can you tell me what the total amount she had? She had 100 rupees. Now we are going to subtract these shopping rupees from the total rupees. Shopping rupees or the spended rupees are 72. So the amount that she left is, total is 100 and the spended amount is 72. Now students, let's subtract it. 2 minus 0 can't be done. So we are taking 1 carry from this one. This will make 10. We again carry toward this 0 and this will make the 10 and this will make the number 9. Okay students, now 10 minus 2 is equal to the 8. Next, in the next step, 9 minus 7 is 2. So students, Anila has left with 28 rupees. Okay, come towards the next part B. Here Alim has rupees 75 to spend. How many rupees he have in total? He has 75 rupees. He buys a pair of socks and a cake. Let's find out the price of a pair of socks and a cake. So students, pair of socks is of 35 rupees. So here I am writing rupees 35. Okay, and the next is a cake. So students, cake is costing 27 rupees. So here I am writing rupees 27. Okay. Now in the next step, we are going to add both of these numbers, 7 and 5. That is equal to the 12. Here I am writing the number 2 and 1 is carried to the tens column. Now in the next students, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So here I am writing the number 6. So students, how many rupees did Alam spend? He spent rupees 62. Okay. Now we are going to count that how many amount he has left. So students, total amount is rupees 75. Let's write it here first. Here I am writing the total amount, that is rupees 75. Okay. Now students, here I am subtracting this amount, that is the shopping amount of Alam. Here I am writing this beneath the number 75. Okay. Now students, in the next step, we are going to subtract them. Dear students, look at this. This is the amount 62 that I am giving to the shopkeeper. And this one is the total amount of the Alam. So students, I am subtracting my shopping amount from the total amount. Okay. Let's subtract it. 2 minus 5 is rupees 3. 7 minus 6 is 13. So dear students, how many rupees did left with Alam? So students, Alam left with rupees 13 out of the total 75 rupees after buying a pair of a socks and a cake. Okay, so now students, look at this in the part C. Sana has rupees 90 and she buys a hairband and a teddy bear. So students, Sana is buying a hairband and a teddy bear with rupees 90. Let's find the price of a hairband and a teddy bear first. So students, look at this. The price of a hairband is 5 and the price of a teddy bear is 75 rupees. So dear students, I am writing it here, the price of the teddy bear and the price of the hairband. The price of a teddy bear is 75 rupees and the price of our hairband is 5 rupees. Now students, here we are going to add these two numbers. 5 plus 5, that is equal to the 10. Here I am writing 0 for the 10. 1 will go to the tens column. Now 7 plus 1 is 8. Here I have written the total price of the shopping that was given by the Sana to the shopkeeper. Okay. Now this price is 80 rupees. So students, the total price the Sana having is 90 rupees. So in the next step, we are going to subtract the amount of the shopping, that is 80 rupees, from the total amount, that is 90 rupees. Now students, let's subtract it. Here I am writing first rupees 90 and then the rupees 80 and after the subtraction. Okay. Here the rupees 90, that is Sana having, and this one is the 80 rupees that are the total amount of the shopping that she wants to. Okay. Now students, let's do the subtraction. 0 minus 0 is 0. Here I am writing the 0 into the ones column. Coming towards the tens column, 9 minus 8 is 1. Now students, this amount is rupees 10. Okay. Now look at this students. Here the 10 rupees is the amount that will left with the Sana. Okay. Out of the 90 rupees, she gave 80 rupees to the shopkeeper while she bought a hairband and a teddy bear. Okay. And she left with how many amount? She left with 10 rupees. Okay, students. Here is the last part of our today's page 106. Students, Lala has rupees 100. How many rupees Lala had? Lala has 100 rupees. Can she buy a pair of socks, a toy car and a can of cocoa? So students, first of all, we are going to calculate the total amount of these things and then comparing with the 100. If our answer is equal to 100, or the number lesser from the 100, which means that Lala can buy. If this is above from the 100, which means that Lala can't buy these things in the 100 rupees. Okay, now starting from the first pair of socks, students, can you tell me the price of pair of socks? Yes, the pair of socks is costing 35 rupees. So here I am writing the cost of the pair of socks, that is rupees 35. Next is a toy car. So students, toy car is of 56 rupees. Here I am writing amount 56 rupees beneath the number 35. Next, she wants to buy a can of cocoa. A can of cocoa is of 45 rupees. Now here I am writing the number 45. Now students, in the next step we are going to add these numbers. Let's add them, starting from the ones column. 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. 10 and 6 is equal to 16. Here I am writing the number 6. 1 is carried towards the tens column. Now students, let's add them. 4 and 5 is equal to 9. 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So this one is equal to the 13. Here I am writing 3 here and 1 into the hundreds column. Now students, by adding the number 35, 56 and 45, we get the number 136, which means that the price of a toy, a pair of socks and a can of cocoa is rupees 136. Now students, in the next question, that is that Lala can buy these things with rupees 100 in total or not. So students, here is the question. If Lala can buy these things in 100 rupees, then you will mark the tick in the yes, and if that doesn't happen, then you are going to mark the tick no option. Okay, now students, look at this. The total amount is 100 and the shopping amount is 136. So students, if you are having 100 rupees, then how can you give 136 rupees to the shopkeeper? This is not possible. You should have more 36 rupees to buy all these things. So students, Lala can't buy these things, a pair of a socks, a toy car and a can of cocoa, with only 100 rupees. Okay, now students, can she buy these things or not? No, she can't buy these things in 100 rupees. So here I am marking a tick for the option no. Okay students, hope this concept of shopping will be clear to you. Now you can easily count the amount of the things that you are going to buy to the shop, and then you can easily subtract the money and give to the shopkeeper. Okay students, try to practice this by yourself. Take care, bete. Allah Hafiz.